WPUG Radio presents Maisy and Daisy.
Hello and welcome, everyone. This is Maisy the Crazy Pug coming to you on this pugtastic evening on radio station WPUG in beautiful downtown Pugville. I am in Studio A and Daisy is in Studio B. It is starting to feel more and more like fall. This week, we had some beautiful weather until we woke up one morning to it below freezing. I am so glad that only lasted one day.
Me too, Maisy. I love the cooler weather, but not freezing weather. I love to see the fall foliage and seeing people and their pets outside enjoying their days. You know, Maisy, we will be seeing a lot of our friends enjoying themselves when PugsTake DC. Unfortunately, we won't be seeing this in person since we aren't going, but I will enjoy seeing their post.
You know they are going to have a lot of fun. PugsTake was started in 2015 after a group of pug friends got together to party and spread the word about pug rescue.
That sounds like what we like to do. I love getting together with our pug friends, and we sure like to spread the pug love and tell people about pug rescue.
That's right, Daisy. Since PugsTake has started, they have been partying and raising money to help pugs in need. They have gone to Boston, Chicago, Las Vegas, New York City, and Washington, D.C. Our friends Milo and Otis are the founders and organizers, along with Bogey and Marcello, Hamilton and Rufus, Violet and Timmy, and Finn. Violet and Finn have left us and gone over the Rainbow Bridge, but their philanthropy spirit is still with us in spreading the word and bringing awareness to the needs of pug rescues everywhere.
D.C. is such a fun city, but when pugs take over, it is an awesome city. Anyone who will be in D.C. the weekend of October 25th through the 27th, you must go to some of the activities they have planned. They have a meetup planned at Swamp Oodle Dog Park, a meetup at the National Mall, and a pug party and raffle to benefit Mid-Atlantic Pug Rescue. We would like our listeners to help them raise money for Mid-Atlantic Pug Rescue. They are asking for raffle donations. Items can be for either dog or human, and they don't have to be pug related. If you have something you would like to donate, please contact PugTakeovers at gmail.com.
If you have any questions or want details of the activities, you can go to their website at PugTakeovers.com. Be sure to click on the link About, then Fact, to find the frequently asked questions and answers, and click on PugsTake, then PugsTake DC 2019 for the schedule of activities. If you go, please tell them that Maisy and Daisy say hi. We sure wish we were going.
Maybe next year, Maisy. It sure would be nice if they came back to Chicago. Even if we can't go, we wish all of our friends who are going have a pugtastic time and hope they raise a lot of money for Mid-Atlantic Pug Rescue.
That we do, Daisy. I love seeing pugs and their humans having fun and helping others. We are such a loving breed, and so are our humans.
Not only our humans, but our friends too. We know some loving Shih Tzus, Min Pins, Bulldogs, Terriers, and more. You know what isn't loving, Maisy?
I sure do, Daisy. Witches. They can be very wicked. That reminds me of a song. Double, double, toil and trouble.
Thank you.
Did you know that William Shakespeare wrote that in his play Macbeth?
Any lover of literature would know that, Maisy. William Shakespeare is a legend. I have a spooky story for you. There was a man who always wore two pairs of underpants. When he died, and when his wife was laying him out to be buried, she only put one pair of underpants on him. After the funeral, the old man's ghost kept coming back to the house. Every night, at the stroke of midnight, the old man would walk right through the front door. His wife was so scared that she moved away. But the ghost found her. She moved again, and she kept on moving. She must have moved 4 or 5 times. But no matter where she went, her husband just kept on coming back. Eventually, the woman couldn't stand it anymore. And one night, when her husband's ghost came walking in, she asked him, "Why do you keep coming back? What in the name of God do you want from me?" He looked at her for a long time. And finally he said, "Honey, please give me another pair of underpants." So she gave him another pair of underpants, and to this day, he has never been seen again. If you wanted to know the title of the story, it was Underpants.
That was a funny ending, Daisy. I have a good one for you, too. The title is Thing at the Foot of the Bed. There was an old man who lived alone in a large old house in the countryside. He always said he wasn't afraid of anything, but he kept a gun with him at all times for its protection. One night, the man stayed up late watching a horror movie on television. When it was over, he climbed the stairs and went to bed. He was just beginning to doze off when he noticed something strange. In the moonlight, he could see something lurking at the foot of his bed. It looked like two big eyes staring right at him. The old man was scared and hardly dared to move. Slowly, he reached out and grabbed his gun, which was lying on the nightstand. The frightened man took aim at the ghostly figure and pulled the trigger. A shot went off and the old man let out an unearthly scream. The poor fool accidentally shot off his own big toe.
Ouch, that would hurt. You should always have a nightlight on so you can see at night. Time for a break from Halloween stories. Let us have a few laughs.
That's a good idea. Daisy, where do baby ghosts go during the day? Day scare centers.
Here's one for you. What do you get when you cross Bambi with a ghost? Bamboo. the ghost repair a hole in his sheet. With a pumpkin patch.
I like those jokes, Daisy. Why did the witches team lose the table tennis game? Their bats flew away.
What do ghosts like to dance to? Soul music, of course. Well, I think that is all the time we have for today. If you enjoy our program, please be sure to spread the pug love with everyone you meet. You don't have to be a pug to spread some love. If you have any questions you want to ask us, or if there are any topics you want to hear about, or if you have uplifting stories you want to share, please message us on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. This is Daisy, best friend and sister of Maisy the Crazy Pug, signing off for WPUG Radio. We hope you have enjoyed your time with us.